Today we will see the next topic from the digital communication as narrowband noise. Okay. Well, in last lecture we have seen what will be the effect of linear filtering on the noise. Now next the narrowband noise. Okay. What is the narrowband noise? For every communication system or at the receiver, in the communication system at the receiver, every receiver receives the the signals which are added with the noise. That's why generally in the communication receiver they have added the pre-processing filter. Okay, what is the use of the pre-processing filter? Whatever the signal, whatever the data coming from the sender through a communication channel, it will be followed by the receiver, and that's why there is a pre-processing device is there, and that pre-processing device before the receiver, it is called as the filter. Okay, this is the filter. Why there is a need of the pre-processing of the device as a filter? Because we are having some additional of the noise data in the original signal. To remove that, we require a pre-processing filter. And this pre-processing filter, it is nothing but a narrow band filter. It is also called as the narrow band filter. Okay. Now, what is the function of the narrowband filter? This narrowband filter contains the whatever the signal from the channel that is given to the pre-processing filter. It is called as the narrowband filter. Now, the bandwidth for this narrowband filter, it is a, as its name indicates, it is a narrowband which passes only the narrowband of the signal. For example, we are having a specific signal or the information which we want to transfer over a communication media channel towards the receiver. At that time, the capability of that filter, it is only which can pass only the signal. Okay, that is nothing but a whatever original signal that can be passed. Whatever the additional noise which already have added, that cannot be passed. That means a narrowband filter is generally employed for the purpose of pre-processing, and the bandwidth for this narrowband filter is just large enough to pass the signals only. That means what we say regarding the bandwidth of the narrowband filter, which can pass only the signal, not a noise. Okay, which can pass only the signal, and whatever the output of the this pre-processing filter, whatever the noise is added, whatever the noise comes at the narrowband filter, it is called as the narrowband noise. Okay, it is called as the narrowband noise. Yes, that is nothing but a, this is the bandwidth of the narrowband filter that is large enough to pass only the signals only. But the bandwidth is not very large as to allow excessive noise. That much bandwidth of this filter is not that much large which can allow the noise also. That's why it is a only limited frequency band, narrow band, which can pass only the signals. Okay, that is a function of the pre-processing filter. Now after that we will see the power spectral density of the narrow band noise. Whatever the output of the filter, it is nothing but a narrowband noise. Now we will see the power spectral density for that. What is a PSD? It is nothing but a power spectral density of the signal. Okay. See that the frequency component for this power spectral density, which contains the components as plus minus mid frequency, is nothing but a plus minus the fc, which denotes by the plus minus fc. We will see the graphical representation for that. The power spectral density and the frequency components of the plus minus fc, that is cutoff frequency. The spectral components of narrowband noise are concentrated about some midband frequency as plus minus fc. That's why the graphical representation of this, and we are having a frequency that is of Common spectral density denotes by the S, then of here it is a zero, and here we are having a frequency for that. Minus fc, and it is of plus fc. Okay, this is fc minus b, this is fc plus b, this is a zero, minus fc plus b, it is minus fc minus b. Okay, and for this we are having figure a as power spectral density narrow band noise. Power spectral density narrow band noise. Narrow band noise. In the form of power spectral density, we can form, we are having a two frequency component. It is called as the mid frequency, fc and the plus fc and the minus fc. Okay. Now, with respect to that, we can show the sample function of the narrow band noise. Okay. We can show a sample frequency for the noise. This is zero, and it is of n of t. Noise represented by the n of t. The frequency components, they can show like this, as we are having a frequency for that. Okay, that's why you can say that the power spectral density for this in this way, and this is a 1 by fc. This represented the 1 by fc, and this is the frequency band for this. And 1 by b, bandwidth b. And the figure which denotes the figure B as sample function of narrow band noise. Sample function of narrow band noise. Okay. This is the power spectral density for the narrow band noise, and this is the sample function of the narrow band noise. Now, how we can explain this narrow band noise and the sample frequency of the noise? Now, this figure shows that the spectral components of the narrow band noise are concentrated about some midpoint frequency plus minus fc. Okay, the frequency component are concentrated at plus minus fc, minus fc and the plus fc, plus minus fc. Okay. Now, narrow band noise is a random process, the sample function of which is denoted by n of t and shown in figure. This is the sample function n of t for the noise, which is shown in figure. Now, here, figure shows that the sample function n of t of a narrow band noise is similar to a sine wave. Okay, this is similar to a sine wave. That's why this frequency is fc, and it undergoes slow variations in both amplitude and phase. There are slow variations in the amplitude and the phase. We are having a phase and the amplitude. That's why we are having some variation in that. Now we will see the power spectral density, yes, n of here. The power spectral density, it is denoted by the yes, n of here. Okay, what we say that this power spectral density, S n of f, it is nothing but we are having one Bloch diagram for that, power structure density. Or spectral density filter H of F. Power spectral density it is represented by the S N of F. We are having a block of filter H of F having the input and the output. Now for this, we are having this H of F, which is nothing but a filter, which is a pre-processing component filter with an input of the W of T, white noise, white Gaussian noise, and the output noise is nothing but a power spectral density, PSD is equal to S N of F. It is nothing but a power spectral density is equal to the which is represented by the output noise, yes, you know, yeah. Now, let the noise produced at the output of a narrow band filter be N of T due to the application of white Gaussian noise. Whatever the noise which is represented by the white Gaussian noise, W of T, which is given to the pre-processing element as a filter, H of F, and we get an output noise obtained, that is nothing but a power spectral density for that noise, and that's why having a sample function of W of T, the white Gaussian noise applied at the filter input has a zero mean and unit power spectral density. Whatever this white Gaussian noise we are having, which is having a zero mean and unit power spectral density. And the unit power spectral density. These are the two important parameters regarding the white Gaussian noise, and this white Gaussian noise having a zero mean value and the unit power spectral density. Okay, that's why W of T is the sample function of the input noise process. And N of T is the sample function of the output noise process N of T. That's why this N of T is nothing but a output noise after the Gaussian process as W of T. That's why let the transfer function of the filter be H of F, so the power spectral density of N of T is given by. That's why the power spectral density plus N of F is equal to mod of H of F square into power spectral density of the white Gaussian noise. That's why the power spectral density with the function of H of F mod square is equal to, because we are having a unit power spectral density. What is the value of this PSD of the white Gaussian noise? It is a unit. Unit, it is nothing but a represented by the 1. That's why it is nothing but a S N of F is equal to mod of H of X. Okay, that's why we can conclude that the shape of power spectral density, which is shown in figure A, is obtained by squaring the shape of transfer function H of F. Okay, whatever, when we square the transfer function H of F, we obtain a power spectral density as a unit. That is the conclusion for this topic. Okay, so today we have seen the what is the narrow band noise. This is the question which was asked in the 2012 in the our question paper, university question paper, for the 8 marks. As question as asked, explain narrow band noise and represented and narrow band noise in terms of in phase and quadrature component. Okay, for that we have to explain what is a pre-processing filter, what is the need for the pre-processing filter, where we can connect in the communication receiver, in the communication system. Then we can draw a graphical representation for the power spectral density for the narrow band noise, as well as the sample function of the narrowband noise. After that, we can explain the power spectral density for the white Gaussian noise. And in this way, we can conclude, we can obtain a power spectral density by squaring a frequency component twice. So that is a narrowband noise which used in the filter. So today we will stop here.